Dear students, today I am going to discuss industrial drives and application module 4. In this we are going to discuss speed control of single phase induction motor. We have discussed the speed control of single phase induction motor, three phase induction motor we have discussed. So the speed control can be achieved by using voltage to frequency control method, and we have discussed the voltage controlled method separately, frequency controlled method and voltage to frequency controlled method. Then we have discussed stator side voltage control method. Then different types of speed control we have discussed for three phase induction motor. And here this controlling technique having different disadvantages. And we know that V by F method, that is voltage to frequency control method, in order to control the speed of the induction motor using three phase, if you increase the frequency or decrease the frequency, the corresponding changes will take place in the flux. Okay. So if the flux is increases, means the magnetizing current will also increase, which is drawn from the supply. And so that your power factor will reduce. Okay. So power factor reduces means the motor will go to derating conditions. Means that the motor windings will get heat up, so that humming noise will come. So iron loss, core loss, everything will be increased. So the motor life will be reduced. The lifetime of the motor will be reduced. So that what we have adapted the next technique, V by F means simultaneously we are going to increase voltage as well as the frequency. Okay. So you suppose if you are increasing the frequency by 2 into F, means the voltage also we are going to increase by 2 into V. So 2 get cancelled, so you will get your voltage to frequency will be constant, so that your flux will be constant, so the magnetizing current will be constant, so there will not be any change in the power factor, so motor will be running smoothly with the proper speed. And also we have discussed closed loop technique by using current source inverter, voltage source inverter. Now here what we are going to discuss, speed control of single phase induction motor, just only theory part we are going to discuss. So here the speed control of single phase induction motor is generally controlled by controlling stator voltage, okay, which can be controlled by connecting a variable resistance in series with the stator. Okay, but this type of method is rarely used because of the poor efficiency. By controlling the resistance at the stator side, it is because of the poor efficiency this method is not using. This is very rare method. So the stator voltage can also be controlled by use of AC voltage controller, that we have discussed in the previous session. And if the available source is AC, then we can go for AC voltage controller. If the available source is DC, then we will go for DC chopper in order to convert the fixed voltage to variable voltage. Okay. So in order to control the speed of your induction motor. So stator voltage, if you are using resistance which is connected in series with your stator windings, and in order to control the speed, the efficiency is very poor, so that we are not going to use. We are going to use the next technique, voltage AC voltage controller. And coming to the speed of the motor, okay, how to control the speed of the motor by using variable frequency control. We know that by controlling the frequency, by varying the time period, we can control the frequency of your motor. Okay, so in order to vary the time, okay, we can control the frequency so that the speed of the motor can be controlled. So however, it is rarely used because of the variable speed application, the variable speed application of single phase motor. the stator voltage control is good enough. We are not going for the variable frequency method. Okay, so we are going to control the speed of the single phase induction motor only by varying the only by controlling the stator voltage, not by using any other method. Variable frequency control we are not going to use. This will be we are not going to use, we are going to use only stator voltage control method, that too by using AC voltage controller. And now coming to the next, here a single phase induction motor, okay, with the main stator windings has no inherent starting capacity. Okay, it does not have inherent starting torque. Since the main winding introduce only stationary pulsating air gap flux, okay, so that the single phase single phase induction motor is not a self starting motor, already we have discussed. And because of this main windings introduced only stationary pulsating air gap flux wave, so that it is not a self starting. For the development of starting torque, a rotating air gap field at the starting must be introduced. Okay, we have to develop the starting torque, and also we have to make sure that the starting torque should be high and the current which is drawing from the motor should be low. Okay, that also I have discussed. The starting torque should be high in order to get the smooth running of the motor. The starting torque should be high, and your the current which is drawing from the motor should be less. That also you have to make sure. Several methods which have been developed for the starting of the single phase induction motors are split phase starting and shaded pole starting, repulsion motor starting, and reluctance starting. These are the different types of starting method we have adapted for starting of the single phase induction motor. And now the single phase induction motor is commonly employed by the method of starting is the selection of the suitable induction motor and the choice of its starting method depends upon the following. Okay, so how what are the starting methods we are going to choose, that will be entirely depends upon these two three following factors. One is speed torque characteristics of load from standstill condition to the normal operating speed. The other one is the duty cycle, and the third one is the starting and running line current limitations as imposed by the supply authorities. So this is about your single phase induction motor. Thank you, students.